magic brocade. Long ago, a widow with her three sons lived in a small village in China. She was famous for her brocades. One day, she went to the market to sell her brocades. At a stall, she saw a beautiful picture of a pretty white house surrounded by green fields. The widow loved the painting and bought it. She went home and showed the painting to her sons. "I wish we lived in such a place," she sighed. The eldest sons laughed while the youngest one encouraged her to weave the design into her brocade. "Weave the image into brocade and it will be as good as living there." She started working on the brocade and her sons chopped wood for living. The widow burned pine branches to work at night. The smoke caused tears to fall from her eyes and she wove the drops into the brocade. The old woman. Years passed by. She kept weeping and weaving a beautiful brocade. At the end of the third year, the widow finished her brocade. It was beautiful and the widow was proud of it. Suddenly, a strong wind blew the house and the brocade flew away. It flew further and further until it had completely vanished. The widow was heartbroken. She asked the eldest son to search for it and he set out immediately. After a month, he met an old woman who was sitting beside a small stone house with a white stone horse. He told her the story of his mother's lost brocade. She said, "The brocade has been carried away by fairies. You must pass through the Flame Mountain and then cross an icy sea without complaint. Or you can take this box of gold and go back home." The eldest son took the box of gold, but instead of going home, he went to live his life alone. The Land of Fairies. Back home, when the eldest son did not return, the dying widow sent her second son to find the brocade. When he reached the mountain pass, he too found the old woman. She told him the story and like his brother, he also took the box of gold and headed to the city alone. Another month passed away and the second son also did not return. Now the youngest son set off to look for the brocade. When the old woman told him the story, he immediately agreed for the journey. The old woman turned the white stone horse into a real one. Next, he and the horse galloped towards east. The youngest son went through the Flame Mountain and crossed the icy sea and reached the Land of Fairies. There, he found fairies weaving copies of his mother's brocade. He asked them to return his mother's brocade. "Tonight we will finish and you may take your mother's brocade," they said. The fairies fed him and let him rest. The Fairy and the Brocade. In the middle of the night, one of the fairies got up and looked at the brocade. She loved his mother's brocade so much that she wanted to be a part of it. So she embroidered a picture of herself in the widow's brocade. In the morning, the youngest son took the brocade and rode off back home. The widow was happy to have her brocade back and she immediately healed. Together, they carried the brocade outside and unrolled it. The picture sprang to life. The youngest son and the fairy fell in love and got married. They had a new home to live in. Then one day, the two eldest sons who had become beggars came upon a lovely white house. When they got to know that it was their mother's, they turned away in shame.
Thanks for watching. Do like, share, subscribe to Sahil Bookhouse.